Yeah, it looks like it's worth it. So if you come back, sister, I'm just gonna pick up where I left off. We know the ones that were picked in Judges. Welcome back, welcome back. We know that the ones that were picked in the Judges, I mean in the, yes, hallelujah. It must be a good word for a timely word for a lot of people because it started acting crazy. It was only two people in here. Glory to God. But they say that the more hearts that are given, the easier it is to stay on. I don't know how true that is. But, you know, they say the more hearts that are given, the easier it is to stay because that's what they count. I don't know how true that is, but, you know, if you don't have a million hearts, it makes it hard for you to reach certain people as well. But glory to God. The truth of the matter is the people that were chosen in the battle were the ones that didn't just go and just lap the water up. They were the ones that, you know, they, like a deer, you know, like David said, as a deer that repents for the water, so my soul thirst after you. They were like the deers. When the deers go drink, they don't just like drink up. They don't just go down their lap. They are very, you know, they watch their surroundings. You know what I mean? They watch, not like a dog. A dog just don't care. Just see, like, I see my dog when it's time to eat. Man, I have to train him to wait, and it's still hard for him to wait. When it's time to eat, he'll knock over everyone, everything to get to that food. And I mean, he, and the being that he's a dog, you know, he's a dog. You know what I mean? And we don't want to be that. The being that he is a dog in nature. And he is a dog that it doesn't matter what it is that's being poured out for him. He's just going to eat it. It could be poison. He doesn't care. He's hungry. He's just going to eat it. So that's another thing. That's another bit of revelation of don't be like a dog. You know, that's what he's saying. You know, be like his children that he's created, his creation. You know, hallelujah. And we see, hallelujah. And let me see. It was a. Let me see. Hallelujah. It talks about how a lot of people. Hallelujah. It talks about how a lot of people in the Bible were eaten by dogs. So yeah, and also a perfect one is 2 Peter 2:22. It happens to them according to the true proverb: a dog returns to his own vomit, and a sow after washing returns to wallowing in the mire. So we don't want to be either one of those, you know. We don't want to be returning to vomit. Like once he gets his free, how will we continue to abide in him? Don't let the little dainties of the world come and try to pull us. I mean, me personally, I can share a bit of my testimony. Me personally, I am a musician, and I was playing, you know, in clubs before he got really a hold of me. And, you know, that people try to get me to, you know, go play still. And I'm like, no, I just play at my church now. You know, I play on here, I worship on here. So that. Trying to get me to return because, you know, being that I'm self-employed, money is tight, you know, you just be like, what am I going to do, you know, and it comes knocking on the door, you know, he leaves for a season, he comes back and tries to, you know, get back in that place, kind of like it says, when you get rid of that, make sure that you fortify that spot. Make sure you fill it in, because he'll come back, find it all swept and clean, and come back 7 times stronger. So I ain't trying to have that. So I'm trying to continue to abide in Christ and share with others about abiding in Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, right. We will not compromise. Amen, sister. I'm in agreement with that. Hallelujah. We will not compromise. Amen. Don't run after God with the whole heart, hallelujah. says, like a dog that returns to its vomit, is a fool who repeats his folly. Yes, Lord, help us to stay focused. Amen. Help us to stay focused in your righteousness. You know? It says, by grace we have been saved. Help us to stay in that grace. And I'm not talking about a soft grace. Yes, changed by your word, hallelujah. In your grace and your holy grace. Yes, not that soft grace. But, and another thing I want to clarify, clear up, is it's not work-based. This is, we are his workmanship. So it's, whenever I say, all my other scopes I've been saying, don't get caught up in works, I'm meaning the works of the flesh. I'm meaning, because it says, you say you have faith and you have no works, but I'll show you faith by my works. But if those works are the works that it talks about, that are being tried, that are going to get burnt up, then that's a work of the flesh. So you don't want to, you want to abide in him, where in him you move, live, and have your being. Everything that you do, everything that I do, everything that we do is Christ-centered. It's not centered on elevating ourselves. It's not centered on elevating our kingdom, but his kingdom. So we don't want to be, yes. Help us to stay focused in your ministry, which is heaven on earth. The simple thing is yes, to see Jesus. The simple thing is to see Jesus always, and to do the works of Christ and wholly submit to know him. Yes, to know, like Moses said, I want to know your ways. Hallelujah. I want to know you. I want to see you. And I want to behold. Hallelujah. Express him. Yes. And the expression of our life, every movement, like me moving my hand, let it be just to glorify you. Let it destroy works of darkness, right? Let us be those accurate arrows shot out. Yeah, be my hands, your feet, be your hands, your feet, all the joint, by their hands, be their feet, Lord. Let them continue. Let us not get into the dog mentality. Let us not be suckered into all those little weights that easily beset us. Let us let them go. Lay aside every weight. Hallelujah. Because you are amazing, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Use us for your worship, hallelujah. Use what you poured into us. Let it be ours together. Let it be totally towards bringing you glory, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. In Revelation, it says, it's Revelation 22:15, it says, outside are the dogs and the sorcerers, and the immoral persons, and the murderers, and the idolaters, and everyone who loves and practices lying. So there's a clear illustration of how dogs are. They're categorized with the sorcerers, the immoral, and the murderers, and the idolaters, and people who practice lying. Lord, don't let us have any part of that. Let us only have the part of abiding in Christ, which is your love, your steadfast love, your abiding presence in our lives, your glory manifested in our lives, your name lifted high. Not our names, not anyone else's names, but only the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So, song that he gave me a few years back, and it's called When You Love Someone. So when you love someone, you give your all in all. You don't do anything to hurt them. You make sure that they're covered. You make sure that you're not offending them in any way. You make sure that it's always good. You keep the communication, the lines of communication are always open. They're not shut down. You're not closed off. You don't become bitter. You don't hold things against them. I agree with you. I am a missionary evangelist. I need a home and a vehicle suddenly. I'm sorry, that last part I didn't get. You need a vehicle, and what else? What else did you need? You need a vehicle and something else. And provision, hallelujah. Well, Father, I'll just agree with her in the finances being, because you says the blessing, your word says the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. Yes, he definitely gave offering for his souls to be brought in, and that's what my sister wants. All she wants to do is bring souls to your kingdom. She's not trying to build your kingdom. She's trying to build your kingdom, Lord. Thank you, Father, that you build your kingdom more and more in her life and use her, Father, that she's an empty vessel to be poured into, Father, for your spirit to be poured into. And she's asking for your blessings that make rich and have no sorrows. Not a man's blessing, but your blessing. Not my blessing, but your blessing that makes rich and adds no sorrow. The blessings of the Lord that make rich and add no sorrow. So Father, we thank you for your blessings pouring out, that she's above only. She's the lender and not the borrower. Father, thank you that you continue to make her the lender and not the borrower, Father. We thank you, Father, that you divine connections for her, the right people that will finance her, that will give her the provision that she needs, the place to stay, Father, that all of that is provided because she's coming to you, Father. She's coming to you for clarity, for how to get it and where to go, and whom she should speak with, Father. Thank you that you begin to show her and have people come to her, Father, that you surround her with that shield of favor, and that could be, send her help from the sanctuary, Father. Send her help from the sanctuary, wherever she may be attending, whomever she's fellowshipping with, that they begin to pour into her, Father, the finances needed, the provision needed, the covering needed, Father. She does outreach ministry. She's reaching out to people and ministering to souls. And it's for your kingdom. It's for your name to be glorified, Father. So we know that we're not praying amiss. We know we're not asking amiss. We're not asking for selfish gain. We're not asking for names to be in light. We're asking for your name to be the light. Hallelujah. Your name to be the light of so many that she reaches and so many that she will reach, Father. So we just plead the blood of Jesus over her, Father, over her finances, that nothing should be lacking, Father, and nothing should my enemies harm her. We cover her, Father. There'll be no backlash, nothing coming against her, trying to thwart the plans of God in her life, Father. We thank you for supernatural provision, Father, for the ministry to be brought forth, that you begin to give her witty inventions and ideas of how to get income, hallelujah, and how to be frugal with what she has right now, to be frugal with the things that she has, to reach as many as she can, and that she doesn't get into condemnation when she can't reach all the people that she wants, because we know that it is a process, and that it's growing, it's building momentum, and it takes time. It's taking time to grow and grow and grow, and that she doesn't become weary in the well-doing that she's putting forth, Father. That there's no weariness, Father. That she rises up with strength, wings of an eagle. Yes, we image it, hallelujah, for now. That she receives strength from you, Father, because it's not by might or power, but by your spirit. That you pour out more of your spirit in her life right now, Father. That she's able to rise up with wings as eagles, hallelujah. Your strength made perfect in her life, Father. Your strength made perfect in her life. Hallelujah. Your strength made perfect, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for those divine appointments and connections, Father. And that, Father, we just come out of agreement with any negative things that's ever been said to her about her ministry or about her not being able to succeed or any negative thoughts, Father. We just bind those up. We take those captives into the obedience of Jesus Christ. Into the obedience of Christ. We bring them into captivity, into the obedience of Christ. We thank you, Father, that they have to obey. Hallelujah. Yes, restitution suddenly. Hallelujah. The dead settlements. Hallelujah. And then suddenly there came. Hallelujah. Like a mighty rushing wind. Hallelujah. We thank you for the mighty rushing wind. And filling her fresh and new, pouring out your spirit, fresh and new, a fresh anointing. The new thing that you're doing, Father, that you receive that. Hallelujah. Right now, the eyes have not seen, the ears have not heard. That it baffles her, even Father, that she's baffled at the growth and the springing forth that's caused by your Holy Spirit. That she will look at herself in the mirror and say, "Wow, God has done it." Hallelujah. And remember, all this, I want to put this on YouTube, and it's under my name that's on here. My name is on there. Just look up that on YouTube, and you'll find me. And remember, all this work that's coming forth, pray over it, because we still have to labor with it, because the enemy is not just going to roll over. He's going to try to stop you. Not saying that he can, but know that he's always going to try to delay it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, yes. And he's a restorer. He's a restorer of all these things. All the cake and worms. And this is not to discourage you, but this was a lesson learned to always listen to the Holy Spirit, because he's always talking to us. We always have to listen. We always have to listen. Even if it seems out of the norm, if it seems crazy, like, everything looks beautiful, everything looks great, even if it looks like it. Yes. But the signs are there. We can never be blindsided as we abide in Christ. We can never be, I speak that over you in Jesus' name. You can never be blindsided ever again, because you're abiding in Christ. As we abide in Christ, you will not be blindsided. And even if they are, hallelujah. Yes, grow wisdom, hallelujah. And even if they are coming against you, that he reveals it, because he says, "Call to me and I'll show you great and mighty things that you knew not." Hallelujah. So that's all that was, is to show that we must abide in him wholly. That millions is nothing compared to what the Lord, yes, that millions is nothing compared to what God can do. You know, he can restore that. So don't you forgive them. That's wonderful that you already have the heart to forgive. Let him come and just cleanse you from that. Let it go. Hallelujah. Let it go. And don't think of the former things. Don't think of the former things, because it says the latter shall be greater than the former. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So don't even think about that. Don't even think about it anymore. He doesn't even want you to mention it. He wants you to thank him for the deliverance. For the deliverance for that. Thank you for him showing you a greater and deeper walk with him. Hallelujah. Yes. Don't even think of the usury, because he says, fret not because of evil doers. That's what his word says. Fret not, because he says, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord. So you don't fret because of the evil doers. Thank you.